This video is sponsored by KiwiCo. More on that later. This is the next generation in actual high-pressure web shooter technology. Portable, powerful, superhuman strong, and one of three brand new pieces of sophisticated, comic book-inspired Spider-Man tech. Building these complex devices was no easy task, and this isn't even the first time that I've built a web shooter. My first web shooter was a backpack system that held enough hot glue to lift a car, yet was lightweight and ergonomic enough to be worn by Spider-Man. After completing that web shooter, I wasn't sure that there was much that I could do to really improve the design. That is, until I saw this. On the other side of the Earth, in our piece of the multiverse, is a guy named JT, who runs the channel Built IRL. JT is a leading expert in web swinging technology, and in his most recent video, he made some truly spectacular advances on the road to swinging like Spider-Man. Watching JT put so much thought and effort into advancing the swinging side of the Spider-Man web shooter lit a fire inside of me. Thinking back on all that I had learned from building all of my hot glue guns, I began to realize that with that great power, I also had the great responsibility to continue the quest towards creating true, sticky Spider-Man web shooters, and maybe even something more. I used to think that fitting full web shooter technology onto just your wrist wasn't possible. And then I remembered one of the most overlooked pieces of canonical Spider-Man tech, the utility belt. Spider-Man's utility belt goes way back to the very first comics, and this is where he keeps his web cartridges, among other Spidey gadgets. In order to properly fire our hot glue web, it needs both heat and pressure, and packing both of these into a small package is no easy thing. So once I realized that the secret to keeping the web shooter small was to outsource the heating aspect to the belt, that's exactly what I did. In order to understand the heating system, we need to first look at the web cartridges. They start out as empty CO2 cartridges with a quick disconnect fitting on one side and a hole drilled in the other. The hole size depends on the web you want to shoot. Tiny for web rope and massive for web blast. I insulated the cartridges with a mixture of high temperature paint and micro ceramic vacuum spheres. Each one of these tiny ceramic balls has a vacuum inside of it, and it insulates just like a thermos. Since the coating makes it difficult to pass thermal energy in or out of the cartridge, I use an induction coil to pass a magnetic field through the cartridge, which causes the metal casing underneath the coating to heat up. The cartridges sit inside of a silicone cup that is wrapped with an induction coil while they heat up from the inside. Once they are up to temperature, they are ready to be loaded and fired from the web shooter. The web shooter was designed to be simple, ergonomic, powerful, and most importantly, look cool. Its core component is a CO2 bike tire inflator that is lever activated. I replaced the lever with some custom aluminum brackets. These rest against your palm and act as the trigger when pressed.
CO2 cartridges have an internal pressure of about 800 psi.
Once activated, the gas leaves the CO2 cartridge, passes out the side of the inflator, and into the pipe that then leads to the quick connect fitting where the web cartridges attach. The web shooter is comprised of two quickly separated pieces, the shooter itself and the wrist mount. The CO2 cartridge in the web shooter snaps securely to the wrist mount via a piece of modified PVC pipe. The pipe is mounted to an anodized aluminum wrist plate. In between the wrist plate and the pipe is the watch strap bracket, cut from aluminum, then bent to secure the strap and embellish the pipe. I ultimately chose the watch strap because it was a simple, sturdy, and attractive looking mechanism that was already designed to easily attach to my wrist with just one hand. I considered using two straps for extra strength and stability, but the single strap fit perfectly and moved more organically with my body.
I love how this turned out. Because it contains no electronics, its simple valve system ensures greater reliability.
And the quick connect system allows for the rapid swapping of a variety of web cartridges.
Even the ones that I haven't invented yet. Unlike other makers, I don't make mistakes when I build things. For instance, I'm a very competent machinist.
The ideal material-based formulas of feeds, speeds, chucking, and lubrication are like a second language that's actually more like a first language for me. Coating the cartridges was also super straightforward. Dialing in the proper surface preparation, paint selection, coating thickness, curing times, and temperatures was a one and done. Oh, and the wrist strap design? It just came to me right away. I never even thought of trying any other stupid waste of money and time. Really, it was surprising how easy the whole process was. I mean, you would have thought that firing the thing properly would have taken some trial and error, or that I would have burned myself with either hot or cold to the point of permanent scarring, but I guess I'm just that good. Even getting the web shooter to hold a ton of weight was a piece of cake, but you're gonna have to stick around to the end of the video to see more about that.
I guess that's why this project was so cheap. I mean, when your comprehensive understanding of specialized technology allows you to elicit the desired result, sans malfunction or damage of any kind, you just don't run into something like a bloated materials budget, you know? Which is why I really don't need a sponsor for this video. So you should definitely never check out KiwiCo. If you would rather not have your kids play with experimental web shooters that might blow up in their face, KiwiCo's new Halloween kits might be a better option for you. KiwiCo is a great resource to learn at home, and they just sent this super spooky light-up haunted house for my nephew Eddie, which he loved. KiwiCo's kits come with everything you need right in the box, so there's no extra trips to the store, which saves you tons of time and effort. Their Halloween projects are available for one-time purchase rather than subscription, so it's a great way to introduce yourself or your kids to KiwiCo if you've been curious. Just like their regular kits, they introduce STEAM concepts in a super fun, engaging way. Hands-on learning was foundational to my education, and so I always advocate it for anyone who wants to really develop their problem-solving skills. So if you are ready to create some spooky memories and start an educational new Halloween tradition for your whole family, go to kiwico.com/joelhalloween and grab one of these scary smart Halloween crates. It's a seriously great way to support this channel. Building this web shooting system was a slow process of trial and error, piece by piece, brick by brick. But there's one last brick that we need to lay, the first brick in building a very important bridge. Until now, swinging and sticking have been two separate endeavors for web shooter builders like JT and myself. That is, until I cut this little piece of metal. This is my first glue anchor prototype, and it's a way to harness the strength of even this small amount of hot glue webbing. Because it is cut out of metal mesh that is full of holes, it maximizes the amount of surface area that the glue makes contact with, vastly increasing the strength of the bond. This anchor is an interface between the rope and the glue, spreading out the weight of the rope onto as much glue as possible. This figurative brick is a literal brick because Spider-Man swings in a city full of them, making it the ideal test surface. And believe me when I say, there's nothing figurative about the strength of this anchor. The anchor system held my weight 14 separate times over the course of several days before it finally gave out. If my first prototype performed this well, just what could future prototypes do?
Yeah, there's absolutely more that we can do. And ever since I got like a taste of swinging like Spider-Man for real, I would love to have more of that. And so getting more developments and maybe just by a bit of a shift in perspective, we'll be able to come up with a whole new way of doing this with fewer limitations and even closer to the real thing.
What if I combined glue, anchor, and rope into a single cartridge? I don't know if it's possible, but I definitely can't do it without you. This new web shooter platform would be ideal for prototyping new cartridges that push closer and closer to the real thing. But people like JT and myself depend on your support to continue this epic journey. So please, like, subscribe, and comment if you liked this video, and if you think it's worth taking another step. I'll see you next time.